What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Critical Overlord here. So this will be my spoiler-free review for The Forever Purge. The Forever Purge is the fifth entry in the ever-ongoing Purge franchise, which it's fitting that this is called The Forever Purge at this point. This is intended to be the last one, but I don't think that will be the case. If the box office performs as well, yeah, I'll expect this Forever Purge title to be very literal when we get more entries, especially considering how things wrap up in this film. But this film is directed by Everardo Valerio, and it's written by James DeMonaco, who, you know, has played a part in the other incarnations of this franchise at this point. It stars Ana de la Reguera, Josh Lucas, Levin Rambin, Tanakh Huerta, Will Patton, Cassidy Freeman, and Veronica Falcon. Now, the film is centered on the characters of Adela and Juan, this Mexican couple who have escaped the Mexican cartel, and they go to this Texas ranch where they are working for the Tucker family, because it jumps 10 months later after we see them escape. They're working with the Tucker family on this Texas ranch. You have Josh Lucas, who plays Dylan Tucker, and then we have his whole family at the ranch with him. This consists of Will Patton's character and others, the characters, again, of Cass... or Emma Kate Tucker, who's played by Cassidy Freeman. Will Patton plays Caleb Tucker. And then Levin Rambin plays Harper Tucker. Now, what ends up happening is this movie is following the events of the Purge election year. Several years have passed since then, because it's made very clear early on that the senator who was voted in the office that abolished the Purge when her presidency was still intact, she got voted out during the next presidency run, I guess, presidential election. And the new founding fathers were put back into power. I'm assuming the economy did not go as she was hoping, because she thought there were other ways than the Purge. But the new founding fathers got their way back in with another election. She was voted out. They reinstated the Purge. And that's how we're here again. Probably one of the most laziest ways to get us another Purge sequel. Because I thought they were going to go full ham with prequels at this point, given that the Purge election year abolished the event. But breaking the cycle of the 12-hour event, not breaking it, I'll say that the American people in this film break that. There's a 12-hour interview for where all crime is legal. We know that. We've known that since its inception. However, there is apparently too much hate, and there is a lot of unhappy American citizens this time around, that they decide that 12 hours isn't enough, and there is a nationwide crisis. Now, this is probably going to hit home a lot more so than the other films, given the climate that we're in, and many people would feel that we're even moving in the direction of these films in ways. But honestly, these films have always been political. There's talk about the border, immigration, the racial tensions that exist. All of that stuff is touched on in this film. My issues really come with how there's very little development for the characters of Adela and Juan, our Mexican couple that we're following. We're given reasons to find them likable, since they are in a position where they are a married couple that have been struggling, and now they have an opportunity to make something out of themselves and, I guess, start a family in America while working under this presumably white wealthy family, based off of the events that unfold as the film progresses. We're not given enough to really care about what happens to them, but this film does offer you some likable characters while you're watching the action-packed craziness that unfolds along the way. Would I say this is one of my favorite entries in the franchise? Not necessarily. My favorite entry was The Purge Anarchy. It was The Purge Anarchy. This film might be a close second, and that's not saying much. These films, they're not that great, if we're being quite honest. They're not that great, but I never found them boring. They weren't boring. The direction in this one might be some of the best direction this franchise has ever had, I'll say, because the energy of it is just felt from start to finish. It's not like a single dull moment. It's just that the writing here for these characters, you're not really given a reason to care about what happens to them. They're one-dimensional in ways, and I think I would say that most of the characters in these films are one-dimensional. You don't really care what happens to them. I think the closest person who might have been given a chance to be someone the audience might care what happens to would be the character played by Frank Grillo, since he was in two Purge films. But otherwise, all these films, they don't offer really many characters you necessarily would care what happens to them, as far as like how they develop them and everything. But the other things that's wrong with the writing here is the way the scares are done. It's nothing but jump scares. Even within the first 10 minutes, we have a jump scare before we even get to see Aunt Adela and Juan get to the Texas ranch. Before we even get that small time jump, there's a jump scare with a flashlight. It involves a flashlight. That's all I'll say. It's just very ridiculous how all the emotions of fear are trying to be evoked from these cheap, half-baked, formulaic jump scares that follow the same cues. You know, you have that moment of silence. There's a character walking around. Camera pans to something, loud noise. Same thing. Camera pans to something while it's silent briefly, loud noise. It's not going to scare anyone. Anyone who's a conscious viewer that's been conditioned to how these things are set up and how they play out, this won't scare you. These honestly have become action-based horror films at this point. They're not very terrifying. There's nothing that I would say is very terrifying in this, other than, of course, how close to home this may hit, given the stuff that has been going on in within the past year and the stuff that is kind of bleeding into this year for a lot of people in ways, and just how unhappy a lot of American citizens are with how certain things are being handled within the country. It's kind of like this film is a representation of what would happen if we hit that boiling point, because The Purge in this one, it's not just for 12 hours again. It continues after that 12-hour cycle where Adela and Juan and the Tucker family are in the mix of this, trying to survive this chaos that's going day and night, because there's just so much unhappiness as far as like the American life from American citizens. They're calling it the Ever After Purge, and this might just hit home to people given the things that are going on. There's even a mention of the American citizens being granted access for 6 hours to go to the borders of other places, of like Mexico and Canada even. So in a way, while the film is fun to watch, it's not written the best. It's probably got some of the best direction, but it's just not written the best. There's no real rhyme or reason to care about what happens to any of these characters. The jump scares are completely unnecessary. There's no real moments where you are made to feel terrified other than from those jump scares. I honestly would give this a 5 out of 10. Let me know what you guys think about this down in the comment section below. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe, turn on post notifications, and miss a video. In the description, I have links to my social media accounts, my Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can message me there. Of course, let me see any movies, news, or reviews I'm going to cover in the future. With all that in mind, guys, I will see you in the next video.